Welcome to the award show for the 9th annual Cherrywood Challenge, Poppy. The challenge is sponsored by Cherrywood Fabrics with support from Mistyfuse and Aurifil. A collection of 225 small art quilts have been juried into an exhibit, and we have selected several to receive ribbons. We award 5 place winners, 12 honorable mentions, 3 judges' choices, 7 staff picks, and 2 sponsored choice ribbons. And there are 4 women who have entered and been accepted 9 years in a row. We'd like to call out special attention to them. And we also have a youth award. We got 2 this year. I would like to thank our sponsors, Mistyfuse, makers of a very lightweight, wonderful to use fusible web, and Aurifil, a high quality 100% cotton thread that works beautifully with cherry wood. All the quilts you see here measure 20 inches by 20 inches and use only 8 fabrics provided in the official bundle from Cherrywood. Some of the quilts also took advantage of the collection of Aurifil threads in different weights, and you will see many techniques and many embellishments. The first category is the Youth Award. These are people under the age of 18 that entered our challenge with the help of an adult, and we love that because it encourages young quilters. Our challenge has gained a reputation of being hard to get into, but these next 4 quilts are women who have entered and been accepted 9 times out of 9. Cindy Wilson from right here in Minnesota. Lori Landry from Michigan. Lisa Ann Giesfeld from Wisconsin. And Shelly Rickey, also from Minnesota. Our staff is so excited when the boxes show up full of these wonderful quilts, and they're tasked to pick their favorites. So we have Cynthia Poco, Alexis Croxon, Evelyn Perendi, Lisa Arthaud, Cindy Myers, Lori Adamites, Teresa Lochname. The honorable mention quilts have amazing detail and workmanship. Ramona Borsma, Ermi Gout, Karen Snow, Lisa Hawker, Denise DeGrandis, Linda Fletchner, Kathleen Mitchell designed a quilt and that door actually physically opens, Julianne Walther, Denise Junick, Allison Aller, Lori Landry, Lisa Ann Giesfeld. Our sponsor Aurifil chose Sheila Reese's quilt as their favorite, and Mistyfuse chose Jennifer Messer's quilt. We have 3 anonymous jurors who go through every single entry and are responsible for selecting the 225 quilts. They each picked their favorite quilt. Congratulations to Sony Ray Dane, Emily N. Smith, and Don Piesta. And now for the prize winners. I would like to start with fifth place and read the artist statements that were also submitted along with these quilts. Fifth place goes to Ben Hollingsworth from Alpharetta, Georgia. His quilt is titled The Yin and Yang of Poppies. The Chinese philosophy of yin and yang holds that the universe is composed of competing and complementary forces of dark and light, sun and moon, male and female, etc. The philosophy is based on balance. Poppies are beautiful flowers with great sentiment and symbolism. They are also the source of opioids, which have wonderful uses as medicines that help relieve pain. However, in some cases, they are abused and used by some in illegal, illicit ways. My piece shows that yin and yang with the beauty of the poppy on one part and the darkness on the other side. Fourth place goes to Lori St. Clair from Nippani, Ontario, Canada. Her quilt is We Will Remember. With a history connected to the Canadian Armed Forces and also as a snare drummer in a military pipes and drum band, for years I was on parade on every Remembrance Day, November 11th. The various sized poppies represent wars and death. Gray poppies are historic wars. Smaller poppies, ever increasing in size as the years pass, are wars of the last century. The largest poppies symbolize wars in the 21st century. The two poppy pods, forthcoming wars. The green bullets are from World War I. They illustrate renewed life in a field of grass. The pinstripe suit, a veteran who each year remembers his comrades in arms and others who made the greatest sacrifice in the line of duty. This does not exclude the many women who also served and sacrificed. The tie exhibits a Trinity knot. I believe fallen members are now resting safely in the embrace of the divine. Congratulations to Kathy Nosley, third place. She's from Festus, Missouri, and her quilt is titled Never to Be Forgotten. Looking through an old dusty box of family photos, I came across long forgotten pictures of Harold Lee Werner. Harold served in World War I, 1917 to 1919. Using John McCrae's poem, In Flanders Fields, as an inspiration, I chose the old faded photos to represent World War I. The present is shown with the bright colorful poppies and the beautiful cherrywood reds, floating memories over the past, forever representing all that have served for our country. This cherrywood challenge touched me personally as I sewed, thinking about the young men in the pictures over 100 years ago, now never to be forgotten. Second place goes to Karen Coates of Highland, California. Ode to the Unknown Soldier, and her artist statement reads, The Remembrance Poppy is the most recognized symbol of soldiers dying in combat in reference to the poppies in the poem In Flanders Fields. The recruitment photo of an anonymous soldier representing hope, the smoke-filled sunsets and barbed wires illustrating the brutality of war, the crosses symbolizing the finality of death, and the poppies that grew over the fallen soldiers' graves, helped to bring alive the poem written to memorialize the sacrifice mankind has paid for freedom. And the first place winner of the Cherrywood Poppy Challenge goes to Michelle Poffel. She is from Braintree, Massachusetts, and her quilt is called A Salute of Honor. As memories fade and time passes, we still pay homage to those who came before us. Poppies are known worldwide as a symbol of remembrance, explicitly in regards to veterans and honoring their services. Poppies have the resilience to thrive through the harsh conditions, like soldiers in battle, and hold the significance of commemorating our loved ones. My grandpa was a World War II veteran, and I chose to use his likeness as the individual saluting. He fades into the poppies, revealing a sense of tribute. The other individuals are silhouetted, indicating that they are gone, but not forgotten. By saluting the others, he is acknowledging those that came before him even looking up at them as if holding them in high esteem. Even though there may be people in life we've never met, there is importance in honoring them. These incredible works will be split into three collections, Petal, Bud, and Seed, and those groups will be booked at venues across the United States all of 2025. Lists of trunks will be posted on our website at cherrywoodfabrics.com, and an email will be sent to each individual so you can see which trunk you are in. We are so excited about this year's Poppy Challenge, and we cannot wait to see them hanging all together at Houston in one big glorious red delight. If you are interested in getting involved in the next Cherrywood Challenge, it's coming up on our 10-year anniversary. We're going to announce the next theme and colors on October 1st of 2024. The due date will be May 15th of 2025. So make sure you're signed up for our newsletter, and we will announce it on social media October 1st. Stay tuned!